Sam is a headstrong, independent woman. What was it about her that you really connected with?
I connected with the story, first and foremost. I really identify with the Hank role in my personal life. Simultaneously, the Dale role. But I know, you know, I read the script and I just couldn't help reflecting on the rifts in my own personal life where that need healing. And so it just hit me, it punched me in the gut. It just hit me in the bullseye target of my heart in that way. And so I began to look at Sam as this kind of usher for him, this sage who gives him the encouragement, the wisdom, the analysis, the love, the friendship, the food in the form of the apple pie. And sends him off on this journey of this prodigal son seeking reconciliation with his dad. And so she had this sort of holiness for me. And then add to that this, at the heart of their story, as far as this being a film about making amends, is the exploration of that very powerful nature of first love.
Was it, and in the same vein of that, was it fun to go toe-to-toe with Robert? I mean, she is such a good foil for him and such a good match for him that it must have been fun to just completely work off each other.
It's fun and simultaneously terrifying. You know, he's got some quick jabs and some blustery uppercuts. And, you know, I'm not afraid, you know, to die. But it is, he's so quick in the impulsivity. His impulsivity is bewildering at times. He acts on everything that bubbles to the surface. You know, there's no hesitation. It's wild. And it's really exhilarating to be opposite. It's electrifying. As an actor, yeah, it's a lot of fun.
There's something in your past, something we do at Empire, we do something called the IMD bunker. There's some trivia on the IMDb that I'm wondering about. There was something about you wanting to be an optometrist.
Indeed.
Before you ever became an actor. Is that
Indeed.
True? And do you think you would have your own business today if you stayed on that route?
I would probably, had I not been encouraged by my peers and professors in high school. I had my heart broken by my first love. And I was playing varsity soccer and I was benched for whatever reason. The coach did not start me. And so I was sitting there forlorn and bored and heartbroken. And I was encouraged to try out for the school play and I got the lead role. And from then on, my peers, I wanted to go study optometry and have my own practice in New Jersey. And in a way, you know, it is a way still of solving myopia, which I think our careers can be, you know. But it's true, yeah. But it was, I was really serious about it. And then I thought that would have been my path.
And to switch back to the show business side of things, obviously you've already directed once with Higher Ground. Do you have plans to do so again? Did it really inspire you to try it again?
I loved it. That was by default, finding myself at the helm of that of that ship. I wanted to play the role. Gosh darn it! I was going to find a way to make it happen, and the permission came with me also directing it. And then in that process of discovery, that it was the story that was really important for me to explore. And I just haven't found that next story. But when I do, yeah. I'll take the reins again.
It's still in your head that.
I had a great. For the moment, I've got so much commitment with Bates and with Conjuring and sort of these franchises that I'm tethered to for the moment. But we'll see. We'll find the story.